Sheila wanted to come, but it was difficult to get away from the house.
It's not easy travelling with young children.
She says she'll come soon. She sends her love.
We know she'll come when she can.
God, oh God, woman, can you not concentrate for 1 minute? And I told you, day in and day out, put your foot all the way down to the floor if you don't want to tear the guts out of the gearbox.
I'm sorry, Daddy. I didn't think.
Blessed will be the day when you start to think.
If it wasn't for you visiting, he'd have gone to bed hours ago. It's very good of you to come so often, Mona. We don't get to see the others so much now. They all have their own lives to lead.
Well, I want to come. So my time's my own.
Still, you'll soon have a man of your own. You won't be beating a path in this direction quite so often then.
Why does Daddy take to his bed so much these days?
Well, he's never been the same since the stroke. He's not ill, though. He just says there's no point in getting up.
Well, he'll have to make more of an effort. You know, Daddy's not as old as all that. He just needs to bring him back to his old self again.
Do you hear from Maggie at all?
She writes. Mind you, not as often as she used to.
Her letters have changed. They used to be so full of fun and gossip. Is everything all right, do you think?
Yeah, everything's fine. Mark finds it very difficult to get regular work these days. I think it's really hard on both of them.
Still, I'm sure it'll turn out all right. And you know how Daddy worries about the family.
There was £5 in there yesterday.
My money. I earned it.
What were you expecting me and the kids to live on? Fresh air?
I was going to replace it.
When?
It's payday tomorrow.
Well, that'll last as long as it takes you to cross the street into the nearest pub. How much is left?
Huh?
Empty your pockets.
What?
I said empty your pockets! Dear God. Is that it?
I give one of the lads a loan.
Now you're a liar as well as a drunk. And Daddy was right. A man who puts the tavern before his family is the worst of all types.
Write a letter.
Of course, Daddy. Who to?
I know that Luke feels I've done him some wrong or harm. I want to put it right.
Michael, you know that's not true. Luke always took things too personally. I mean, there are differences in every family, but no one pays them heed the way he does.
I want him to know I've nothing against him. If I write him that, at least I'll feel the fault won't be mine. It won't be in my conscience. There are times in my life when I have pondered my sanity. Things have been done that cannot be undone. My life is now too short to keep a grudge. Let me say, I had no wish to harm you in the past, and I have no wish to harm you in the future. And if I have done so, I'm sorry. The daffodils are in bloom, also shrubs and fruit. Why is it that in the prime of life, we never notice the amazing beauty that surrounds us? I'm tired now, Daddy.
Excuse me, but are you waiting for someone?
No, I'm on my own.
It's unusual to see a beautiful woman keeping her own company. If you're looking for company, perhaps you'd allow me to buy you a drink.
I've just had tea.
I thought you might like something stronger.
I know what you were thinking.
I'm sorry. I must have made a mistake. I hope I didn't offend you.
I was waiting for someone. But it looks as though they're not coming now.
It's no fun sitting all alone in a place like this, is it? There's something I should tell you. I'm not free. I'm married.
It's all right.
I've never done this kind of thing before.
I'm sure you haven't.
I couldn't help noticing that you're not married yourself. Or did you take the ring off? Some of the women do that.
Thought you hadn't done this kind of thing before.
I'm surprised a woman like yourself wasn't snapped up long ago. You can't have been short of offers. I didn't intend to insult you.
My house, the room.
That's hardly necessary.
It's best to keep things clear.
Look, I'd like to see you again.
You're a married man?
But these things can be arranged.
There's a letter from Daddy.
What does he say?
He's letting the cattle go. He says it's getting too much for him and Rose these days. He wants us to visit.
What, do you want to go?
I can see you don't want to.
Not me or the baby he wants to see.
That's not true. Daddy's devoted to the baby.
It's just all a lot of trouble. It'd be easier if Rose and him came to Dublin.
He won't do that.
I know. Because he won't do anything he doesn't want to. It's time he understood we have other things to think about now. The whole world doesn't revolve around him, Sheila.
That's not fair.
You said it yourself often enough.
Well, I can say anything I want to. He's my father.
And I don't understand why you always defend him. You said yourself he was always on your backs, remember?
He always did what he thought was right. That's something you know nothing about.
Obviously, I don't.
Shall we go then, or what?
You go if you want to, okay? I'll look after the baby.
I won't go.
I'm not stopping you.
We'll go some other time.
Dear Daddy, I want to assure you that after all this time, I feel no bitterness and have no wish to reproach you over things that happened so long ago.
I would not want the relations between us to be a source of pain to you. If I hurt you, it was not intentional. I'm well and happy. Your son, Luke.
Any of it, anyhow.
Goes to the meadow. He just stands there. Wonder what he sees.
Has he? It's not even 8 o'clock yet.
He only stayed up because you were coming. If it wasn't for that, he wouldn't have gotten up at all.
He never missed saying the rosary in his life.
It sometimes slips his mind these days.
We'll have to do something.
I don't know what can be done.
Look, we'll have to try.